Welcome. In this video, I'm going to tell you the truth about YouTube hearing test videos, show you the test results of this 1958 Bozak speaker, use the speaker to test my family's hearing, and play a range of high-frequency tones so you can test yours. As you'll come to find out, though, such so-called tests aren't real tests at all. Take a look at these videos, for example. There are dozens of them proclaiming to provide legit hearing tests, racking up millions of views all over YouTube. Just look at all of them. If you think visiting a doctor is inconvenient, you might just convince yourself that YouTube is a suitable replacement for a trained medical professional and click on one of them. First, you'll usually be greeted with some fun facts. Human hearing ranges from 20 Hertz to 20,000, and the older we get, the harder it becomes to hear high-frequency sounds. Grow real old, and you'll no longer be able to hear the birds sing or your microwave beep. The video has you sucked in and tells you to get ready for the tests. It'll be simple, but 100% accurate, you know. Just listen as the tone rises from the lowest frequency of 20 Hertz all the way up to the highest frequency of 20,000 Hertz. When you can't hear the tone anymore, stop the video to see your result. The test begins and you hear a tone that gradually rises in pitch. It gets more and more difficult to hear, and when it finally disappears, you stop the video. Your result? About 15,000 Hertz. Uh-oh. Apparently, you're going deaf because you're only 18 and the test says you're supposed to hear up to 19,000 Hertz. Or, hooray, you're 55 and have the ears of a 30-year-old. The test proves it, right? Wrong. First of all, no matter what your age, high-frequency hearing varies greatly between individuals, and while it's true that you'll lose high-frequency sensitivity as you age, it doesn't mean your range of hearing is the same as everyone else your age. Is there a cause for concern if you're 18 and can only hear up to 15,000 Hertz? Maybe, maybe not. Only a doctor can tell you that. Some of the videos are at least responsible enough to tell you that if you're concerned, you should do just that. And some videos mention that the results may not be accurate due to the limitations of your headphones or speakers. Absolutely true. Many inexpensive speakers won't play as high as 20,000 Hertz. And some tell you that YouTube's audio compression may get in the way of an accurate result. But wow, if that's the case, why did they even post the video? Didn't they even test for that? Well, I did, and here's what I found. First of all, if you watch any of these videos using the Safari browser, you're only going to hear up to about 17,000 Hertz. In my test, that's as high as Safari will go when playing YouTube videos. None of the videos mention this fact. Although Anechoic does have a pinned comment about it, it's incorrect though that Safari can't play as high as 16,000 Hertz. Something else these videos don't mention is that despite what you see on the screen, the video may not actually be putting out the claimed frequency. The good news is that I found some tests do output a signal from 20 to 20,000 Hertz, but most really drop off in volume after 10,000, making the high frequencies difficult to hear. Worse yet, some tests don't have any signal at all beyond 15,000 Hertz, and one particularly poor video cut off at 13,000. Yes, it is possible to create a good high-frequency test in YouTube, but it takes some care to prepare the video correctly, care that some creators didn't care to take, or perhaps they simply lack the technical skills. So which videos do I recommend as good hearing tests? None. While some have decent frequency tests, not one is an actual hearing test. And frankly, I'm appalled that anyone would put a video on YouTube and claim otherwise. Just because a video can produce a signal from 20 to 20,000 Hertz doesn't mean it's a hearing test. As I've shown, some tests can't even do that, and there are far too many other variables to provide such a critical assessment over the internet. A hearing test requires certified equipment, a sound-isolated room, and an audiologist to administer and evaluate the test. If these videos made it clear that they're for entertainment purposes only, I wouldn't be so hard on them. But most don't, and I can only imagine how many people have gotten themselves needlessly concerned after watching them. And oh, I just love comments in videos that have no output beyond 16,000 Hertz from people claiming to hear up to 20,000. Yeah, sure you did, pal. Inadvertently, I recently set up my own flawed but interesting hearing test. It happened when I was testing this antique speaker. To test the speaker, I placed a calibrated microphone 1 meter in front, surrounded the small area with acoustic absorbent panels to reduce the influences of room reflections, used my audio test software and interface to feed a 20 to 22,000 Hertz sweep tone to an amplifier, which sent the signal to the speaker. The output was captured by the microphone and the results displayed in the audio software. Here's me actually testing the speaker. The red trail shows the output of the speaker, and the blue trail the noise in the room. Bozak, the speaker maker, claimed in 1957 that this speaker could output sounds as low as 40 Hertz and as high as 16,000. My tests show this to be about right, as that's where most of the output is. Remarkably, though, the speaker still puts out audible output across the entire range of human hearing. In fact, it goes a bit beyond, extending as low as 18 Hertz all the way up to 22,000. Note that there are a few dips and peaks in the speaker's frequency response. Because my test setup isn't ideal, I can't tell if this is from deficiencies in the speaker or from room reflections reinforcing and canceling each other out at different frequencies. I discussed this issue in my video, Let's Stuff the Speaker. If you're interested in learning more, I'll leave a link to the video in the description. So we see that just as with a hearing test, speakers should be tested under ideal conditions. Special rooms are built for this purpose called anechoic chambers. Most people don't have that at home, so just as with YouTube hearing test videos, YouTube speaker test videos should be taken with a grain of salt, including mine. Now, I told you that my speaker test turned into a flawed but interesting hearing test. Let me explain.
Okay, so as I was doing the speaker testing, I noticed that my hearing at 53, 54, whatever I am, has cut off at about 15,000 Hertz. So I thought it might be fun to bring some family members in and see just how high they can hear. So I have my wife here in the hot seat, and thank you for helping. And she's gonna tell me when she can stop hearing the high frequency tone and see if she's about 15K, or perhaps maybe she can hear a little higher than I can. She's a little bit younger. You ready?
Yeah.
So it's going to start out as a low tone and work its way higher. And press the button when you can stop hearing the tone. Okay. Yep, you're right about 15,000 Hertz, which is the same for me. But when you click the stop button, I could actually still hear the tone. So I can hear I could probably go for another half a second maybe. Yeah. And hear just that little bit more than you can. You're tapping out just before me. But again, we're both in our early 50s, early to mid 50s, and I'm a little older. But interestingly, my high frequency hearing is just a tiny, tiny bit better than my younger wife's. Thank you so much.
Okay, you're welcome.
Okay, I've got my daughter in the hot seat now. It's raining pretty loudly outside, but I think she'll still be able to hear over the rain noise. And we're gonna give you the test now and see how high you can hear. Okay, Mel, thanks for helping out. You ready to start?
Yep.
Here we go. You could hear all the way up to that?
Yeah.
Oh my God, I stopped being able to hear it like 2 or 3 seconds before
oh, really?
That. Oh my gosh, that's amazing.
Oh, hold wait, on. What was that at?
I'm gonna check and see, I need my glasses. Okay. You heard up to, not quite 20,000, but up to, I can only hear up to this point. You made it all the way to there.
Oh yeah.
You're at about like 1750 or
yeah.
so. So you've lost a little bit of your high frequency hearing. Do you want to try it again and see, or do you think that was pretty much where you were?
No, that's pretty much where
that was it.
Yeah.
Did it get really low and then all of a sudden just disappear?
Yeah, it disappeared when I stopped it.
Yeah. Okay. I'm going to do something. You're going to play it. I'm going to tell you when I stop hearing it. Gone. can't hear it.
I can still hear it.
And you can still hear it.
Yeah, it's still going.
Still?
Still. I can still hear it.
Still.
Okay, it's gone now.
Gone. See how much longer you could hear it than me?
Yeah.
That's incredible.
That's crazy.
Well, that just goes to show. And I'm sure when I was your age, I could hear it too, but
yeah.
As you get older. But 15K, even for somebody like me, is pretty typical.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Amelia. That was a lot of fun. Thanks for helping.
Of course.
Test you again in 20 years.
At this point, I'm guessing you're probably wondering what the highest frequency you can hear is. Well, I've got a deal for you. I'll play an audio test, but you have to promise me not to take it too seriously. Get ready, it's gonna get a little loud. Okay, so if you listen to that in the Chrome browser and your headphones or speakers are up to the task, you just experienced an audio tone that went from 1,000 Hertz to 20,000. I know because I tested it. For fun, go ahead and post your results in the comments. But if you want a real hearing test, listen to me loud and clear. Step away from the computer and see an audiologist. To stay updated, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive notifications when I release new videos. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. I'll see you soon.